Last December, I was providing Wireshark training, and I got a question about CSV data. If it's possible to make a dissector for CSV data and how to do that. Now, I work for Enviso, and we have clients for which we provide private training. So I will give training on malware analysis, malicious documents, Wireshark. And here I was providing training online because of COVID on Wireshark. And in the first day, we covered all kinds of topics of Wireshark. And second day, writing our own dissectors in Lua. Now, let me show you a capture file here. It's actually a file that I constructed. It's not something that I captured. So this is a TCP connection. And this is the data of that TCP connection. As you can see here, 0 pipe character, 1337 pipe character, KKKK, and so on, pipe character command. So the data that is exchanged here over TCP consists of different fields. And the fields here in this example are separated by a pipe character. But since Wireshark has no ID of this protocol, it is not dissecting this protocol, and you just have data. You don't have the individual fields. And I created a CSV dissector to split this up in different fields. So after I got the question, I looked into this and I made a dissector in Lua for this. Let me close this. So this is how I'm going to launch the dissect. So I launch Wireshark. Here it's on Windows, but on Linux and OSX, it's the same thing. Uppercase X as option. And then we can provide a Lua script, CSV dissector Lua. So this dissector will be loaded in Wireshark. And then we also open the same capture file that I just opened. Let me do this. And now you can see here, you see, instead of data, you see CSV dissector protocol data. And if I click on this, you can see the different fields. Here, they are selected. So field 1, 0, you see, well, like this, you see it being selected here. 1337, KKK, command. Now, the fact of having this also makes that you can filter on this, for example, with display filters. If you look at the bottom, here you see the field is CSV dissector.field2. So I can say, for example, CSV dissector.field2 equals 1337. And it's not a number, it's a string. So I put it in quotes like this. And now this packet gets selected. Can also say if it is not, and then you don't see anything. This dissector can be configured. There is only one parameter that can be changed here through preferences, and that is the separator character. So here it is a pipe character, but that is something that you can change. For example, a comma like this. Yeah, and then, okay, we only have one field because there is no comma here that separates. I can change this back. Separator. Pipe character. Okay, and now we have back our fields. You can also make other changes to the behavior of this dissector, but that is something that you have to do in the script itself, in the Lua script itself. So let me close this. And let me open that script here. Let's zoom in a bit. Okay, so here you have some values that you can change. For example, you can change the name of the dissector itself, CSV dissector. You can put in another name. This is also the port on which it will do its dissection by default, 1234. You can change this, 4321 for example. This will now be the default port. Let me save this. And now if I do this again, it's not recognized, so it is not dissected. However, this is something that you can always do with Wireshark, that is, say here, right click decode as, and then you can say, so you see there is no the default here for port 1234, but you can say, okay, I want you to dissect this as CSV, here CSV dissector, like this. And now, as you can see, it gets decoded. So that is one of the things that you can change. The port name here. Also, the maximum number of fields. That is something that also needs to be defined in the dissector. And this is here 10. Now, you might want to make this bigger, of course, if you have more fields. But also make this smaller for the following reason. If I type now CSV dissector, sorry, and here you can see I have 10 different fields, although only four fields from 1 to 4 are actually present. So you could change this to 4 and then don't have that many fields. So that's one thing. Another thing is also that you can give names to each field instead of field 1, field 2, and so on. So let's say that field 2, that's actually the port. So here in field names and here above you can see an example with fields 1 start, field 4 command. You can say field 2 equals port. Let me save this and let me launch this again. Yeah, I should have changed the port also back to 1234, so let me do that. Okay, and now you can see here field 1, but the field 2 is name port, and it is indeed port. As you can see here, you can say CSV dissector port.